What an amazing day out here in the public gardens. This is a great place to get some inspiration for what you would like to plant in your own garden. Gives you a great idea of how plants combine and how they grow over time instead of looking at small plants in pots. I'm Scott from Gardenworks. Today I want to show you some great early spring perennials like winter heathers that are a great transition plant. There's so many to choose from to really kick off your early spring garden. One of what I think of as the underrated plants of early spring is the drumstick primulas or Primula denticulata. They just put up these beautiful straight blooms that come up to or stems that come up to around 15 centimeters high and then have a big ball of flowers in purple, mauve, shades of white. And they seem to do well in a part shade to full sun location in the early spring. Great choice. Here we are in the middle of the Pachysandra patch. Pachysandra is an underused or not thought of so much as a perennial because it's a great evergreen ground cover, but it's a fabulous early spring bloomer with white flowers that on a warm day are quite fragrant. Really reliable, fabulous perennial. Here's another fabulous early spring blooming plant. This perennial is a Wanda primula. It actually comes in mostly in these purple shades, but they have released some gem tones of the Wanda primula that you can watch out for. It makes a great border plant, small clumps, or a full border of early spring blooming. It's probably been blooming for a couple weeks already, maybe more, and will bloom for several weeks more. So makes a really great statement. And boy, I tell you, you can really see it from afar. So it really draws your eye to the garden when you have a patch of this primula. Here we are back at the garden center after a little walk through the park. Trying to bring just a few more of the early spring blooming perennials to your attention. There's a few early spring blooming perennials that would trail or cascade over rock walls if you plant them atop the wall or in a rock garden. And two of the most popular are the Aubretias and the Candy Tuft or Iberis. So this is an evergreen candy tuft that includes beautiful evergreen foliage and white flowers. And the Aubretia comes in quite a selection of colors, including this kind of a purple and a vibrant magenta. There's also a white, and there's a softer mauve color. So really good choices for cascading over walk wall. They're iconic perennials you see everywhere. We've also got, I'll mention one of my favorites, which is the wallflowers. I remember these all the way back to my childhood. Great early spring bloomer with fragrance, full sun location. It's a really good choice. And then we talk a little bit about this amongst ourselves here at the store and at the garden center. And you know, there's not that many early spring blooming perennials that are actually had some height to them, but the euphorbias are one. I've got two cultivars here. One is Ascot Rainbow, which has got a very, very gold and burgundy variegation to it. And then the flowers come out. So it's almost an evergreen foliage and then gets these great flowers on it in the spring. That's pretty showy. This one's even more showy though. This is the variety called Glacier or Glacier Blue with blue foliage with a white margin. And then when the spring blooms come, they're really stunning. And this thing will grow up to about 30, 36 inches tall. There's other varieties of euphorbia like Wolfinii is the one everybody really knows that get even up to 5 feet high, all with these big blooms in the spring after they bloom. Then you can cut them back, keep them bushy, and they create a really bushy, dense perennial, great for the back of the border. Well, it's just a few of the great early spring perennials, from the primulas to the Pachysandras to these Aubretias, the euphorbias. There's many others. Get out and visit a garden for inspiration. Pop by the garden center, and you can visit our website as well. There's a blog about early season perennials that will be very helpful for you and a great reference. Thanks for watching. For more gardening tips and advice, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel.